Looking for some free software to make some quick graphics? Stay tuned. Hey everybody, welcome to Mina Studio. I'm Nathan, and with me as always is my tech director, Ronald. Thank you, Ronald. Today we're going to take a look at Photoscape X. So here we are in Photoscape X. You can see all of the tools we have on top here. Today we're going to spend most of our time in the editor because we're making a simple graphic. You also have the viewer, which is as it sounds, to view the photos. You have batch editing, which will edit multiple pictures at the same time. You have collage, which if you're going to make a collage, this is actually a pretty good program to do so. As you can see, the simple collage is easy to make. You can combine pictures, create GIFs, print. You have other tools like screen capture, color picker, which I have not used yet, and store. Right now, let's go back to the editor where we'll spend our time today. As you can see here in the editor, we have all of the files on our computer here. We're going to go to YouTube graphics. We're going to go ahead and make a thumbnail for this very video we're making right now. So let's open this incredibly exciting screenshot of me staring at you. And now we are editing this photo in the editor. You can see all of the editing tools up here in the top corner. The first one is just simple editing tools like resize, crop. It's got some fun stuff like miniature and bloom. Really simple adjustments like grayscale or sepia. And then if you click that plus there, you have even more adjustments. Auto levels, auto contrasts, reduced noise, all kinds of stuff there. Down here you have the more professional editing tools like levels, curves, channel mixer, color balance. And these are what you'll need to purchase the pro version for. Now, since we're just making a simple graphic today for YouTube, we don't need to use those, so we'll just stick with the simple free editing tools today. So the first thing we need to do is crop. YouTube thumbnails are 16 by 9, so let me make sure my picture is 16 by 9. You can see over there, you can also select other sizes or free or custom. We are 16 by 9. There we go. So next, we're going to go to the color tab. So in the color tab, we'll see some simple adjustments. Brighten, darken, dehaze, lighten, shadows, contrast, saturation. If you click this plus button here, you'll see more like exposure, gamma correction, brightness. These are all we're going to need to use today. We're actually not going to use a whole lot here. I think all I will do here is maybe lessen the contrast and brighten the picture a little bit. That looks good. So today I think we're just going to make this picture very bright, so we can add some black or colored text on top of it, make it a little more interesting. So that's all we're going to do in the color tab. Next, let's go to the film tab. So the film tab is where you'll find all of your filters. Here are your categories of filters up top. The film ones are the kind of Instagram-y filters. I think they're actually pretty good. Then you also have duotone. Light leaks, which I actually use light leaks pretty often. You just got to use them subtly. Let's see. I don't want the hearts in mine. I kind of like that one. Let's use that one. And then down here, let me move myself. So down here, you can see you can adjust the amount of the effect in there. For this light leak, we're going to go pretty small. And then you hit apply when you're ready. You can also undo if you don't like the effect you did. You can redo as well. You can see the original by holding this button, or you can compare what you just did with what it was previously before you added the current effect. So that looks pretty good for now. Let me slide this back over. All right, so we're also going to add some film filters. We want to make it lighter, so I like that one. Let's add that one, apply. And then let's add, let's see. I like picnic blanket. Strange name, but I like it. I'll hit apply, and there we go. So we're just brightening this up right now. That is all we're going to do in the filter section, but there's lots to explore here. Next, we have frames. We're not really going to do anything in frames, but as you can see, there's tons of frames you can use. I don't use these very often, but there's a lot of them. There's also lots more you can add by purchasing the pro version of the software. As you can see, there's some that are really good and some that are, well, you know, not so great. So we're not going to add any. Actually, I kind of like these. Let's add these. I like these. So we're going to add that frame. So hit apply. And there we go. Next, we're going to go to the Insert tab. And the Insert tab is where we're going to do most of our work today. This is where you'll do most of the graphic design things. Now, you can't replace a software like Illustrator or Inkscape with this piece of software. That's not what this is for. These are just simple graphics for things like emails or YouTubes or things you just need to add some text and some effects to. So let's go over what is in the Insert tab. So you can see up here, we have stickers, image, figure, text, magnifier, and filter. Stickers are stickers. We're not going to use any of these today, but if you want to put a giant heart on your picture, then there's a giant heart for you. I do not want that giant heart, so we will delete that. You can also add images to your picture, other images. So as you can see, we can just pick this random sermon image off my computer. Like, you know, if we wanted to do a picture-in-picture look like that. And you can see it'll always bring up this inspector palette on this side, and you can do all kinds of stuff with them, like adjust angle or opacity. You can transform, add drop shadows, all that. That'll come up with pictures or stickers or figures or text or anything you're adding. Again, I don't want that, so we will delete that. Next, we have figures. This is similar to stickers, I guess, but these are just more basic shapes. Could be useful if I needed to add a giant number 5 on my picture. I don't need to today, but, you know, kind of like that. Maybe someday I'll do something like that. Don't need that. We'll go to text in a minute because we are going to do a lot there. Next, we have magnifier. Magnifies a part of the screen. I don't need to do that. I don't know why you would need to do that, but it's good to have it. And then filters add simple filters like mosaic, jitter, blur. If you've seen the intro video on the Mina Studio videos, you've seen that I use the newsprint filter for that. We are going to use that one today. We're going to make it a little less drastic than this. So let me expand the filter out to fill the whole picture. And I'll take the strength here and put it way down, like so. And there we go. So the next thing I want to do is bring down the contrast a little more. And a good way to do that is actually to just add a transparent shape on top. So you can see here we have some simple shapes that we can add: arrows, lines, squares, circles, and you also have outlines of those shapes. So we're going to choose a square. And then you can just draw it on your image, like so. So make sure we get the whole image here. It'll kind of snap to the sides of the image. All right, well, that's not what I want, but I do want something like this. So we can adjust the opacity, and that'll kind of fake bring my contrast down so we can add words on top and they'll stand out. Again, you can do things like adjust the angle and transform and outline and stuff. I don't want to do that. So I think that looks good for a YouTube thumbnail. And now we're going to add text. So one of the things I like about this program is you can do multiple text boxes, which you can't always do in photo editing programs. So we're gonna add a couple here. Let's do blue, shall we? I like blue. Let's go Photoscape X. There we go. I do not want that font, so I'll change the font. I think I like DIN condensed for this. Sorry, I have a lot of fonts on my computer. Designer problems. There we go. Photoscape X. And then I also like that you can expand the text with the arrows instead of just increasing the font size like this. Makes it a whole lot easier to get exactly what I want. Since this is a YouTube thumbnail, the text will need to be ginormous so people can read it when it's tiny. All right, there we go. I think we're going to increase the... Actually, I kind of like that. A little transparent. All right, let's go to our other text box. Let's make it graphic design. So graphic design. with. All right, let's use Din Condensed again and make it black so you can see it. There we go. Move it over here. All right. I think I want those lines closer together, which you can do by going to More Options here. And you can adjust the letter spacing, which I don't want to adjust that, or the line spacing, which is, both of those are very useful. So let's get the letters close, expand it like so. All right, I like that. I think now we need a line. So we'll X out of our text inspector and go back to our top bar and click line. And then we just draw a line like so. I actually like how thick that is, so I'll just keep that like that. But if I wanted to, you could adjust the thickness. Let's go right about there. That looks pretty good. Adjust the opacity. I don't need to do that. All right. If you wanted to, you could add other shapes. There's also like outline shapes like this, as well as circles and stuff. But I think that looks pretty good for now. One last thing I will do is I'm going to put the letters closer together in Photoscape X so that I can make it slightly bigger. All right, we'll need to make this just a touch smaller. Just click on each one and you'll be able to adjust it. And there we go. I think that will be our thumbnail for now. Thumbnail obviously won't be that big, so let's hit our zoom down here just to see what it'll look like smaller. Looks pretty good, stands out a lot. It's not super complicated. All right, so when you are done with your graphic, we have our options on the bottom to save it. Now the save options actually took me a little longer to figure out than I'd like to admit. So you have save, which will save over the original file. You have save to, which just saves it to another place. You have save as, which saves a new file. That's what we'll do. And you also have save project, which will save the editable project in that crazy format there, PSXPRJ, it's the Photoscape format. You can also adjust your quality here, metadata, file data, DPI. It's fine right now since it's going to be a thumbnail. We're going to shrink it down so much that it's not a big deal. So we'll click Save As. Let's do Photoscape Thumbnail. I'll save it to my desktop for now. Save it as a JPEG. You can also save it as a PNG. And there we go. There we have it. So that is how you do simple designs with Photoscape X. Again, it's a free program for Mac or Windows 10. And it's a great program for doing these simple things. It won't replace the big programs like Illustrator, Photoshop, or Lightroom. It doesn't do any of those things that well, but it does everything decently so that you can make great thumbnails and emails and other simple graphics. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, I please ask you to subscribe to Mina Studio so you can see more tech tips and gear reviews for the small church.